Hello. So I'll be honest, I wasn't too excited about making this video because, mostly because of my voice, because I don't like sitting here and telling you that my name is Emma. but I don't like doing that. The deep voice telling you, you know, this name is really bugging me a lot. But I want to make more of these, and right now, I'm just gonna have to suck it up. So this video is gonna be all about messages to my future self. But essentially, yeah, this topic really stuck out to me, because one of the things that I am worried about with my transition is whether I'm making the right choice or not, and I've had a couple of affirming situations, you know, just stuff where my brain has gone, oh yeah, honey, you were supposed to be a woman. Sorry about the mix up there. But I still have a lot of doubt. One of the most recent ones actually was when I was making the follow-up appointment to see my endo. So I called in and they straight up told me they don't have any appointments until March, which March, I mean, it's months away. And I got legitimately depressed because I thought, well, I mean, this isn't until March. I'm 22. Okay. And for me, I'm kind of dysphoric about my hips. And I know that this is around the age where bones fuse. All right. They stop growing, right? Especially the growth plates on the hips. All right. Once you get to around my age, you're lucky to see any hip growth. All right. So I'm sitting here thinking, I can't wait that much time for an appointment. You know, I'm racing against an invisible clock that might have already hit zero. But you know, either way, the faster I can get in, the better for me. All right. And not just to help the dysphoria, but to help me Stay at peace, yeah? So this lady that I called in, she told me they could get me in sooner if I were to see a different doctor. So I did, and I've got an appointment in January. This is great. I'm going to see an endo in January, and I'm going to get this show on the road, and then I can get hormones, I can start voice training, you know, we can do all the hair removal and all that fancy stuff. It's going to be fun. Well, I mean, I don't know if it's going to be fun. The hair removal might be painful, but still! But despite everything, I still think to myself, is this really the right thing? Am I really trans? You know? This started out 4 years ago, right? Started out with some friends talking about the stuff, and that got me thinking about it, and I thought, well, am I trans? So I did a bit of soul searching, and I thought, okay, yeah, probably. So what do we do about it? Well, nothing at the time. And then I kind of forgot about it, and other life things got in the way, like vision problems. Those were real fun. Okay, I like the deep voice for doing the sarcasm, all right? That I'm going to miss the deep voice for that. Maybe I can keep it around, but probably not. So all that happened, and then it resurfaced a couple of months ago, and I thought, well, I should probably do something about this time, since it kind of came back on its own, which again, another affirming experience, but I still have doubts. For me, the message that I would want to ask my future self, and all right, hello, Emma, from a year or two or three or whatever from now. Hey, how are you doing? It's me. I'm sitting on that ugly green couch you have in the dark with the doors closed to try and keep all the noise out. How are you doing? Was it worth it? Was transitioning worth it? Is your life better now? Has it changed for the better? Do you feel better? Do people treat you the way you want? Was it the right choice to make? Because I'm not going to lie. Me, right now, all right? 2018 or, well, 2019 now, I suppose, me, is kind of scared, all right? You see all the reports in the news
about transphobia, people being fired, people being killed. It's depressing. It's kind of scary. So, my future self, I'd like to know, do things get better once you're on the other side? I hope so.
Thanks.